by the name of Allah, the most gracious and most merciful. My dear students, we have already in the last lecture the following points: the purpose and format of the company's income statement and balance sheet, and we know already how to build these statements in Excel with data for any company. In this lecture, we will know the purpose and format of the company's cash flow statement and build this statement in Excel, and also we will examine how to link worksheets together so that formulas in one worksheet can reference data in another and update automatically when changes are made. Building a statement of cash flow. The company must participate in two kinds of financial transactions: those that increase the cash balance is called cash inflows or sources of funds, and those that decrease the cash balance, that's called cash outflows or uses of funds. One way that a financial analyst can determine how well a company's management is performing is to examine how they are managing the shareholders' money. The accounting provision has developed the statement of cash flows, which is useful for this type of analysis. The statement of cash flows summarizes the causes of changes in the company's cash balance. Essentially, it converts the accrual-based net income into cash flow. The changes in the cash balance can be determined as follows: beginning cash balance plus cash inflows or sources of fund minus cash outflows or uses of fund, we have ending cash balance. The statement of cash flows is organized into three sections according to how the cash flows were generated. The first section is cash flows from operations, which are generated by the firm in the ordinary course of conducting its business. The second section is cash flows from investing, that result from buying and or selling long-term assets such as land, buildings, machinery, and long-term securities. Finally, we have cash flows from financing, which is resulting from obtaining or repaying long-term capital. This includes the changes in long-term debt, common equity, and payment of dividends. In statement of cash flows, the most obvious source of operating cash flow is sales and other revenues, and the most obvious uses of cash are the company's expenses. However, we already have this information on the income statement and don't need to repeat it in the statement of cash flows. Therefore, instead of putting nearly the entire income statement into the cash flows statement from operations section, we will only enter net income, which is a summary of the income statement. In addition, we will add back the depreciation expense and other non-cash charges. Why? Because there was no cash outflow associated with the depreciation. Finally, the rest of the entries on the statement of cash flows will be changes in balance sheet items. So, a few will be left out for reasons that we will discuss now. Unlike the income statement and balance sheet, which are mostly exercised in data entry, the statement of cash flows is primarily made up of formulas. Because these formulas reference mainly different cells in the workbook, it is generally easiest to use Excel pointer mode when entering them. To begin, first, you should insert a new worksheet and rename it Statement of Cash Flows. Then enter the labels as shown in this slide and apply our custom number format to cells from B5 to C21 as shown. In cash flow statement, the first two items under cash flows from operations are net income and depreciation expense. As we mentioned, these are unique items because they are the only ones of the statement of cash flows that come from the income statement and also are the only items that aren't represented as changes from a previous period. Also, realize that net income summarizes every other item on the income statement. If we were to include sales, for example, we would be double counting. Now, to enter the net income from income statement, first type an equal sign in cell B5 and then click on the sheet tab for the income statement before pressing the enter key. Excel will change to the worksheet containing the income statement. Now click on cell B15 and press enter. At this point, Excel will switch back to the statement of cash flows worksheet and the formula in cell B5 should be as follows: equal income statement B15. This formula directs Excel to pull the value from cell B15 on the income statement worksheet into B5. If we change some values in the income statement, any change in net income will automatically be reflected in the statement of cash flows. We can make referencing other sheets slightly easier if we display two or more sheets on the screen at once. We will use this technique to complete the statement of cash flows. First, switch to the income statement sheet and then click the new window button on the view tab. This will open a second copy of the workbook. Click the Arrange All button and then choose Vertical from the dialog box. You should now see two identical copies of the workbook. in one of the cupboards. Click on the sheet tab for the statement of cash flows. In cell B6, type equal and then click anywhere on the income statement. Now scroll down to that cell B10 is visible and click on it and press the enter key. The formula in B6 of the statement of cash flows should read as follows: equal income statement B10, and the value should be 20,000. If you didn't already apply the custom number format that we used on the income statement, then you will need to apply it now. How? First, you should select cells from B5 to C21 and then select format cells from the right click menu and apply the same custom format. Or you can click on any cell in the income statement worksheet and then click the format pointer icon on the home tab to copy the format. Now select cells from B5 until C21 on the statement of cash flows worksheet to paste the format. The value in B6 will be displayed as 20. Also, the actual value in the cell is 20,000. The rest of the statement of cash flows can be completed in a similar manner, except that we will be calculating changes in balance sheet items. Because we are done with the income statement, we now want to display the balance sheet in the copy of the workbook. Click on the sheet tab labeled balance sheet. You should now have both the statements of cash flows sheet and the balance sheet displayed. At this point, we must be careful with respect to the signs of the numbers entered into the statement of cash flows. In general, an increase in an asset represents a cash outflows. I mean use of funds. A decrease in an asset represents a cash inflows, a source of funds. Liability and equity items are exactly the opposite. We represent uses of funds as negative numbers and sources of funds as positive numbers on the statement of cash flows. This table shows the signs of cash flows for the statement of cash flows. As an example, the company accounts receivable increased from 351,200 dollars in 2015 to $402,000 in 2016. Because the company invested in accounts receivable by making more loans to customers, it represents a use of funds and should be indicated with a negative sign on the statement of cash flows. On the other hand, the accounts payable balance increased, and because it is a liability, represents a source of funds. It will have a positive sign on the statement of cash flows. The formula for the change in accounts receivable in cell B7 should be equal balance sheet C6 minus balance sheet B6. Because it is an asset, we are subtracting the newer value from the older value as shown in the last table. The change in inventories can be found by simply copying this formula down to cell B8. For liability and equity items, the direction of the subtraction will be reversed. This will ensure that the sign is always correct no matter how the numbers change. Calculating the change in accounts payable in cell B9 using the formula equal balance sheet B14 minus balance sheet C14. Then in cell B10 we would like to calculate the change in other current liabilities with the formula equal balance sheet B16 minus balance sheet C16. Now we calculate the total cash flows from operations in cell C11 using the formula equal sum B5 until B10. Note that we have skipped over the short term notes payable. That is because notes payable isn't an operating current liability. Generally, any interest bearing liability is included in the cash flows from financing section. Also, changes in interest-bearing assets would be included in the cash flows from investing section. If you are paying close attention, then you probably notice that we haven't included the change in the cash balance in this section. Why? Because the change in the cash balance is the final result of the statement of cash flows. We will calculate that by summing the subtotals from each of three sections. Cash flows from investing are those cash flows generated from investment in long-term assets. In the case of this company, plant and equipment realize the investment in long-term assets. Note that we don't use net fixed assets as that would result in double counting depreciation expense. This change can be calculated in cell B13 by the formula equal balance sheet C9 minus balance sheet B9. Even so, we only have one number in this section. For consistency, we will calculate the total cash flows from investing in cell C14 with the formula equal B13. For the final section, our first item is the change in notes payable. This item increased from $200,000 in 2015 to $225,000 in 2016, representing a cash inflow of $25,000. In cell B16, enter the formula equal balance sheet B15 minus balance sheet C15. Next, we can calculate the change in long-term debt with the formula equal balance sheet B18 minus balance sheet C18. Even so, common stock didn't change during the year. It should still be included. In cell B18, enter equal balance sheet B20 minus balance sheet C20. Cash dividends paid to shareholders in 2016 were $22,000. This is calculated with the formula dividends paid equal net income minus change in retained earnings. Dividends paid are always a use of funds. So, in cell B19, enter the formula equal minus income statement B15 minus balance sheet B21 minus balance sheet C21. Notice that the parentheses are important in this case, and that the result should be minus 22,000. Again, we can total the cash flows from financing in cell C20 with the formula equal sum B16 until B19. Finally, in cell C21, we calculate the net change in the cash balance by adding up the subtotals using the formula equal C11 until C20. Notice that this should directly equal the actual change in the cash balance from 2015 to 2016. Otherwise, you have made an error. The most common errors are likely to be either a wrong sign or an omitted item. Take care, my students, of this error. Thank you, my dear students.